mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve.
You sing it with us this time.
Oh, what a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve.
Well, we greet you today from the International Apostolic House of Prayer, and we're also brought to you on the House of Acts Radio. We welcome you to our Bible study this evening, and I want you to know that God has not brought you to hear this broadcast by accident, or to see this MP4 or 3 by accident. You are here in the plan of God to be encouraged today. And I want to read three psalms in your presence, and I believe that these psalms will encourage somebody there that's in difficulty. And I know that you'll be able to relate the words of these psalms and to share them with others. The first one is found in Psalms chapter 3, verse 1 through 8. And the scripture says, Lord, how are they increased that trouble me? Many are they that rise up against me. Many there be which say of my soul, there is no help for him in God, Selah. But thou, O Lord, art a shield for me, my glory, and the lifter up of my head. I cried unto the Lord with my voice, and he heard me out of his holy hill, Selah. I laid me down and slept. I waked, for the Lord sustained me. I will not be afraid of 10,000s of people that have set themselves against me round about. Arise, O Lord, save me, O my God, for thou hast smitten all mine enemies upon the cheekbone. Thou hast broken the teeth of the ungodly. Salvation belongs unto the Lord. Thy blessing is upon thy people. Selah. Are you the people of God? Are you a part of God's people? Then this is your promise tonight. This is your promise today. Oh my God, you have smitten all my enemies upon the cheekbone. You have broken the teeth of the ungodly. Salvation belongs unto the Lord. Thy blessing is upon thy people. Selah. The blessing of the Lord is upon those that call upon the name of the Lord, that serve the Lord, that believe in the Lord, that give their life unto the Lord, and he protects us. He honors us in such a way to protect us and to encourage us and to provide for us. Why does he do that? Because he loves us, and because we have a covenant with him to in turn love him and honor him and give him our very best. If you're in trouble tonight because you're a Christian, I want you to take courage in these verses, that God has given you the promise of protection over those that would hate you for your faith in God. I want to read another scripture that's found in the book of Psalms, Psalm 56, verse 9. When I cry unto thee, then shall my enemies turn back. When I cry unto thee, then shall my enemies turn back. This I know, for God is for me. In God will I praise his word. In the Lord will I praise his word. In God have I put my trust. I will not be afraid of what man can do unto me. The vows are upon me, O God. Thy vows are upon me, O God. I will render praises unto thee, for thou hast delivered my soul from death. Wilt thou not deliver my feet from falling? That I may walk before God in the light of the living. David said it, I will not be afraid what man can do unto me. And if you're living for God today, if you're honoring God with all of your life, and your family honors God with all of their life, then you have an assurance from God Almighty that you are protected. You are honored. You are favored. You are provided for. And even though people might come against you and speak against you and try to do badly to you, you have the last say-so. You are the one that is honored. You're the one that is to be encouraged today. Psalm 34, verse 15 says these words, "The eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous, and his ears are open unto their cry. The face of the Lord is against them that do evil, to cut off the remembrance of them from the earth. The righteous cry, and the Lord hears, and delivers them out of all their troubles. The Lord is nigh unto them that are of a broken heart, and saves such as be of a contrite spirit. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him out of them all. He keeps all his bones, not one of them is broken. Evil shall slay the wicked." Listen to this. "Evil shall slay the wicked, and they that hate the righteous shall be desolate." I want you to know tonight that if you are a person that loves God, if you are enjoying the fact that you have his righteousness upon you, it doesn't mean that we're righteous in ourselves, but we know the righteous one. And consequently, that's the righteousness that we carry as the people of God. The Bible says that when people come against you, when they come against you to talk evil against you and to hurt you in any way or threaten you in any way, you can know that God is watching over that situation. He will keep your bones, but the promise is to the wicked that is coming against you, he will be broken. His teeth will be knocked out. He will lose his balance. He will lose his family. He will go through hardship because he has chosen to persecute the child of God. The Bible says if somebody comes against you as a Christian, you rejoice because it's your honor that they have done this. God is being lifted and glorified by the fact that you are being a Christian with a right attitude in the face of danger and difficulty and hatred from other people. Oh, but I tell you what, pray for that one that comes against you. Pray for them because you will see with your eyes the punishment that comes upon them. You will see with your own eyes the difficulty that they will bring upon themselves because they have chosen to hate a righteous child of God. I want you to be encouraged today. If you're under any kind of persecution, if you're under any kind of difficulty, if anybody at all is giving you trouble because of your faith in God, you pray for them because God is watching and God will not allow that to go on forever. You believe with me. We're trusting God for your safety. We're believing God for your well-being, your help. We're not going to say that you might not even lose your life. Well, any of us could do that because of our service for Jesus Christ, because our Lord himself gave his life. But I'll tell you this, your life will not be given in vain. Your life will not be tormented in vain, but God is watching you. He takes account of every sacrifice that you make and every difficulty you go through for his name's sake. Be encouraged today. We are praying for God to have his perfect will in your life and in your family's life, and you will not be disappointed for having made the decision to live for Jesus Christ. We're praying for you, and we need your prayers to pray for this ministry, that God can use us and encourage us to do the things that must be done for the cause of his kingdom's sake. We love you very much. If you're able to communicate with us, we would very much like to hear from you. But if you're not able to, we understand that you're going through trouble and difficulty, and we pray for you. If there's anything that we can do to help you in our prayer or in any way at all, let us know, and we will certainly do all that we can. We honor God tonight that has given us this opportunity of fellowship, that we can share the Word of God together, that we can pray together, and that we can have this time to share God's Word with you. We encourage you to come back again and hear the words that God would share with us through this broadcast. And thank you so much for your listening. We pray tonight that God will bless you and that he will keep you, make his face shine upon you, and that he will provide every need that you and your family and your fellowship has wherever you are in this world. in Jesus' name. Thank you so much for listening to the International Apostolic House of Prayer. My name is Prophet.